I gotta tell you, Ma, you outdid yourself. These stuffed shells are outstanding.
Fred?
Here, have some more. Your father always likes the spaghetti. I wanted to make something special, just for you. Next one.
Whoa. Basta already. There's no way I'll eat it all.
You can't get too much shit. They're just the right shape.
Whatever you say, Ma. I'll have some of that bread. Please.
You should hold off on the bread.
But I gotta have some bread. You just gave me more shell.
It's two starches.
What?
It's two starches. Italians don't eat two starches at the same meal.
Since when?
Since always. It's always been that way. Remember when we went to my father and Nunzio's place in Rome,
mm-hmm.
and you asked for bread with your pasta? It stopped the party cold. And everyone looked at me like I'd raised you wrong. It was so embarrassing.
Yeah, but then they gave it to me anyway.
You were just 6 years old. They thought you were cute. But the look they gave me, it said,
"This better be temperament, or else."
Or else what? Well, what are we eating it for then?
Don't argue, eat your shells.
We've had bread and pasta forever.
And it was wrong.
Well, Dad's eaten it.
Your father has experience. Eating two starches hasn't messed up his life.
And mine's messed up?
You're young. We just want you to be happy.
I'm happy already. I'd just be happier if I had some bread. Jeez!
I made the shell special for you.
Your ma's crying.
I didn't do anything.
You made her cry! After she did all this trouble for you, making your shell.
I'm sorry?
You think she works that hard for me? You think she makes me shells?
I worked hard my whole life.
You stayed at home.
You raise a family of eight.
I did. I went out. I worked. I put a roof over their heads. I clothed them. I fed them. But that is not. The point is that your mother went to all of this trouble for you, and you don't give a good goddamn.
Please don't say that.
Huh?
When you say, you're taking the Lord's name in vain when you say good goddamn.
You see how she keeps the family together?
And I did make you stuff shit.
Once. Just once. You made it for me once, and I got better.
What are we talking about?
Your father's just saying that if you do the right things, then you got nothing to worry about.
I wasn't always the best husband or father.
Whoa.
It's all right, Mary. Our son needs to know these things.
No, he does not. He just needs to eat Michelle.
What did you do to my shells?
What do you mean, what did I do? I baked them.
What'd you put in them?
What I always put in them. Ricotta, mozzarella.
Drugs? Are you trying to drug me?
What?
What kind of a pervert accuses his own mother of such a thing?
I'm just confused.
You see? I knew it all along. I knew you were just confused. And you didn't trust your mother. And all I was trying to do was to get you to understand.
Understand what?
That two starches don't belong to
you. Okay, Mom, look, you gotta help me out here. We sit down at the table, and I ask for bread. And you say, no, it's two starches. And then you say, eat your shells. Your father ate his shells, and he got all better. Right? But he's eating two starches.
He
has experience, I know. But we normally have spaghetti, which is a starch, and we have it with bread. So what's with the shells?
All right. Put out your right hand.
Now see, that's what I
wanted. Now put out your left. Now, look at the bread in your right.
I really want the bread.
Yeah, that's enough of the staring.
Bread.
Could you hold on a minute?
Yeah, Dad, we're using it.
I'm out of bread.
Well, I didn't get it.
Hey, 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 no yelling at the table. Pass me the bread.
Hey, I wanted the end piece. I didn't get any, you know. There's some over there.
Don't you dare. Not this house, you don't. Joseph, just do this one thing for me, all right?
Okay, so I look at the bread in my right hand.
No, I mean, you did that already, so you don't need to do that no more.
So we can get back to the eating.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
Now look at the shell in your left hand. Allow yourself to gaze deeply into where all the rich, creamy filling has been stuffed. And it's bursting from within. How does that make you feel?
All warm?
Yeah, yeah.
And moist?
Yeah.
And kind of shriveled from the sauce.
But the slit! The slit! What about the slit?
For Christ's sakes, Mary, have him lick it, just like you did with me.
I was getting there. These things take time. And don't take the Lord's name in vain. Do what your father says, Joseph. Lick.
But
do it!
But couldn't I just put this on there and eat them both together?
No, it don't work that way. Go in. Try again. Yeah, now. Isn't that something? It's really the only way to eat the shell, you'll see. Warm, moist. So much better than that hard, hard meat. And if you work it a little longer, you'll get to the surprise. making us fast.
What's wrong with my spaghetti?
Would you please not interrupt me? I'm talking here. Your father's spaghetti's all right. I'm just saying that a thin noodle only goes so far.
There is nothing wrong with my noodle, and you know it.
Please. Now you're doing just fine. Close your eyes. Feel the sensations wash over you. Here, let me tell you. You want to start out all gentle, working from the outside in, breathe in the aroma, taste the earthiness, you know, the porcini, the prosciutto. Takes you back to the old country, where you had to make everything in small, dark places where the flavors ripen. Then, you gradually bring your tongue closer to the slit. Taste the filling. Still all respectful and gentle like a twig. And then you start to tease the treasure chest open so you can get deeper into the cave for all its goodies.
Wait, Mom. Can I have some bread now? Mom.
She's gone. I've seen it once before when she had me do it. It'll be a while before she comes back up for air. Would you give me some more bread, son? Oh, wait. There's another loaf in the bread box. Get some for both of us. Thank you, son.
Sure thing, Pop.
You know, you're a good boy, Joseph.
To two starches!
To two starches!